Hello and welcome one and all back to Ori and the Blind Forest. My name is Josh Jepson, but you knew that already. Today, I'm not sure what we're doing today. We're trying to make our way to the tree still. But last time we pretty much did, we pretty much did the majority of our first little dungeon here, but it looks like there's quite a bit left from, that unlocked from our map stone that we uncovered. So let's just, we'll just keep going in this direction then. This is the gate we opened at the end of the last episode. We also in the previous episode unlocked the ability to wall jump, which is nice to have, you know, when you're trying to get around places. Wall jumping is generally a good thing to have in your abilities here. Let me save, because I haven't been doing that as often as I should be, and I want to get into the habit of saving and also, like, reusing my saves as well. There's a keystone. Oh, God, I tried to double jump, and that did not work at all. Ouch. Oh, God. Oh, there's another keystone. Nice. And I see a life thing up there. Is that what that is? No, the life things are green. Ugh. The things that I said looked like energy tanks. Not looked like energy tanks. Acted like energy tanks. Son of a gun. Man, platforming is something else, isn't it? Platforming! And this is suddenly where the game, like, actually causes you. The cause of my stress is platforming. If you've been watching me long enough, you'll know that I'm not the greatest at platforming 2D side-scrollers. I've never been that great at them. And no matter how many games I play, I don't seem to get any better. So no promises here with this game. I've heard that it gets really hard, which I talked about before, but hopefully I will come out on the other end of this a-okay and in good shape here. I'm trying to get up there. I think I can just jump from here, because I think there's a hidden hole with something in it. What is this? These energy gates were sealed by the spirits of the past. If we collect enough energy cells, they will open a path. So I have one energy cell. Two energy cells, and I don't have enough, but I see one down there. Can you see it? Can you spot it? I don't know if you can. I can. Okay, well, we definitely don't have enough energy cells for that right now. I'm assuming that that's some sort of upgrade down there, perhaps. Can I destroy these? Because I can't get up there otherwise. So never mind. Now, how about that? How do I get down to that? It looks like I might have to access it from the other side. Is there another side to this? Oh, no, but there is, hang on, let me go back down here, because it looks like I have to get to it from over here. Somehow. Pray tell, how do I get ye? No? Fine. I'll take my chances with the thing shooting fireballs out of the walls. How do I get that? You guys are going to have to tell me how to get that, because I don't actually know. Maybe I get another ability or something. I'm not sure here. I'm trying to see if there's any walls that I can just walk through. It doesn't appear to be the case. Soul Link is ready. I will remind myself to use it regularly. That's the thing that's running through my head constantly now. Is just, don't forget to use your Soul Link and save, you fool. Don't forget to use your Soul Link and save. Oh, Jesus, Grandma! Okay. That was intense. But I did it. Spit your fireballs. Your fireballs. I can't talk either. Ooh! Okay, hang on, wait a minute. There's a... Oh, this is how I get up here. I was like, how do I get up there? That is how. Man. I'm looking forward... Oh, God. I'm looking forward to seeing what they can do with this game, because... Oh, wait, do I have four? Okay, I do have four, thank God. Oh, it's bugging me, though, that I don't have that thing. I'm gonna go back and look around really fast, because it's bothering me that this is down here and I can't seem to get to it. Unless, oh, you know what? I'm willing to bet that I get the double jump at some point. Like some sort of double jump move that allows me to go up through the floor somewhere there, like jump around. Speaking of jumping around, I'm quite good at this actually. I'm getting the feel for the controls finally, which is nice. I don't have a Soul Link. Somber, they found me dormant and still. We told Ori the tale of her misguided will. Ori, the spirit tree. He must have used the last of his strength to save you. Come now and hear our story. It was the night of the light ceremony. It was our light that she hated. I called out to Ori, but my child never came. Oh my God. Oh no, 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 no! So a giant evil owl came and stole the heart of the spirit tree. Are you serious? Kuro stole Sign. It was the end of our days. Oh, Sign! Our little light friend. Well, we found Sign. You received the spirit light's tree. The spirit tree's light. He put our fate in your hands. Listen carefully now, for you must understand. That owls are scary? The spirit tree sustained the three elements of light, and they turned, and in turn, they brought balance and kept Nibel safe. The element of waters, high atop the Jinso tree. The element of winds, deep within the forlorn ruins. The element of warmth beneath the fires of Mount Horu. To restore Nibel to its former self, we must rekindle their light before it's too late. The first we will find beyond the spider coves, atop the tree where the waters once flowed. The light of water. We have to find the spirit tree there. Okay, so there's spirit trees throughout the world that we need to find and kind of find all the different lights that goes to them. The light that we have is this spirit tree, or like the hub spirit tree here. Now, before we go on, I know there was something up to the right over here that I didn't get to before. It doesn't look like I can actually get past this. As much as I would like to, it doesn't look like I can currently. Because I have not unlocked the ability to blow up cracked, glowy walls. So instead, we'll just have to go all the way this way. Cool. My God. So we're kind of learning a little bit more about what happened to the world here. The glowing from before, that was the spirit tree calling to Ori. Be careful, Ori. The ground is unstable. The glowing from before, and our friend Naru actually came and... Oh, I see. Hang on. Ha 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 ha, you did. Our friend Naru, like, tried to save us, but in turn, like, ended up kind of messing up the world because, you know, the spirit tree needed us. That was why it was calling out. Because we are kind of the hero. We're the light. Alright, can I get up there? I don't think I can make that light or that jump, so I'm gonna have to go down into the deep dark hole of death that I dropped this fool into. Sorry. Yeah, that didn't work out. Also, I should probably save. I need to start reminding myself again, because that didn't really help. Come at me, bro. Got something for you. Bye-bye. It's called gravity. Oh, 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 Christ. Okay. Jeez. It's all right. I'll save down here. Although I don't want to get into a position where I save with, like, one health. Oh, I thought I had an ability. I do not have an ability. But I can hold this to save my game again. I'm willing to bet that I'm going to be coming across that double jump that I was talking about. Because this feels like a game that would include a double jump. And that little, like, cliff, getting over that cliff, is impossible without some form of double jump or boost jump or glide or something. RT to grab objects and move, or just activate a switch. I also saw, like, a glowy spirit light thing up in the corner there that I want to go get. Somebody in the comments said that it wasn't too terribly difficult to 100% this game. So I'm going to do my best. Is this something that I can break? It doesn't really look like it. I can't grab it or do anything with it. So I guess that's something that I'll come back to later. There's an energy cell over there that I could definitely use. But let's just keep going down. I'm afraid to, like, drop down on top of something. Because who knows what other weird, monstrous things were dropped down here. Found a spirit light container. Spirit light has been added to your meter. Find more spirit light containers to quickly gain ability points. I feel like I've found one of those before already, though. So I don't know what's going on here. I was touching on this a little bit earlier, but somebody in the comments suggested that I get the... makes most pickups show up on the map. I think that's what I want to get, right? Are there other things here? Ability markers. Marks ability cells show up on the map. Okay, so ultimately there are markers that we can unlock here for our maps in the ability tree to show all this stuff on the map. So I'm going to start with that and work my way up there. I don't know if it's something I'll focus on, but... it's definitely something to think about, because if I want to 100% the game, if I want to go through and get all the collectibles, that's going to be the best way to do it, is to have it all show up on my map. So, man, they are just blocking me left and right. I'm thinking that maybe the next ability is not a double jump, and it is in fact a bomb of some kind, or some sort of spirit bomb that, like, destroys these walls, because they're just inconveniently placed. Speaking of power-ups, Anno. The spirit that died here was strong and courageous. Listen to his voice. He was able to focus our light. Oh, maybe it's some sort of charge attack, actually. Now that I'm thinking about it. I like guessing what power-ups are going to be. Yeah, charge flame! Use this ability. Hold X to charge. It's not X on my controller, but... also, a lot of people have been saying... Yeah, I've seen a number of comments that are like, I wish I could play this game, but I don't have an Xbox. You guys realize that I'm playing it on the PC, right? I'm playing this game on the PC. Ooh, charge. And ooh, okay, so you charge up and it sort of turns into like a spirit bomb kind of thing. Interesting. Which means I could probably blow this up. Yeah. Cool. Cool, cool. So I'm playing it on the PC, not the Xbox. I don't know what gave you... that idea, other than the fact that it's Xbox buttons all up in town here. Wait. How come I can't charge it? Oh, you need... Oh, it uses energy cells. That's why. Okay. I was like, why can't I use it? I can't use the charge attack unless I use or have an energy cell. That's actually kind of crazy, because... I thought the energy cells were just for saving, but you have to share the energy cells, or share the points. There we go. Now I can go break down in here. Here, I'll reuse that just because. That's such a helpful ability, being able to reuse that, now that I know that blowing these up. No, now I understand why there's energy cells all over the place. Because you actually need them for some of your abilities. I did not know that. Get out of here. Okay. So where are we at here? I feel like we've been here before. Yeah. Yeah, so this is over on the other side. And there's this whole other place up in here. Holy crap, there's a lot of things here. A lot of things. Okay. Can I get up there now? No, I can't get up. Of course I can't get up. I don't have any way of double jumping. As much as I would like to have something like that. I wonder why it's leading me back around here, because I've already been here. I mean, I guess I have a new ability now, so I technically unlock certain collectibles. There's that there. Some of these are things showing up on my map that, like, I already have, but I know that the glowing bits are, like, the spirit things, right? What am I talking about? You know, I try to sound intelligent, and then I just don't. All right, so if that's the case, let's see here. Where am I headed? Ultimately, I'm headed over there, so I want to head back this way. It looks like there's a gate over here that requires four, I'm assuming four keystones. And there's a keystone there. But I don't see any other keystones on the map, so there's got to be a place where I have to go and just, like, discover it. So there's all this stuff up here, too, that I have to remember. But we do have our shortcut here, but let's go back, because I feel like there are things up there that I'm missing. And that's probably the case. But ultimately, we need to work our way over to the far right of our map. Save again, just to be on the safe side. Just to be on the save side. See what I did there? I made a pun. Oh yeah, I activated that thing up here. I never actually went up here and did this because I got distracted with all the stuff, the shenanigans going on down in the hole there. Down in the hole down there. Wait. I just had an epiphany. There was that cracked wall over to the far left here. I don't want to forget about that. I know there was a couple other cracked walls. I can't remember where they all were. But this one is the most recent in memory that I can get through. Boom! Valley of the Wind. Oh, I don't need to come up here. Oh, Valley of the Wind. That's not where I want to go. I want to go way over here. Valley of the Wind comes later. Oh, God, and there's... Oh, yeah, this is not my home. This is not where I want to be. Okay. Okay, screw that noise. As much as I like the idea of going over there now, I'm not going to. I'm gonna go a different way. This is not where I want to go. Although there were some collectibles over there that I feel like I should go and get. But instead, I'm gonna make our way up this way. And we'll make our way around this. We got that little switch earlier that dropped this down. There's also that way over there that it doesn't seem like I can really get to, all the way over to the left. But it's definitely something I can look into at a later point in time. But for now, I'm going to end this episode of Ori and the Blind Forest. If you like this video, please hit like. Don't forget to leave a comment. I enjoy seeing your comments and reading them. I enjoy seeing you guys kind of following along and discovering this game along with me. Once again, I am playing this on the PC, so if you do want to play the game alongside me, download it on the PC. I'm sure that most computers could be able to run it. Not necessarily maybe as smooth, but, you know, lower the resolution or whatever. You can play it on your PC. Unless you have a great gaming PC, in which case, what are you waiting for? That is going to be it for me today. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next episode of Ori and the Blind Forest.